Hi students, let us continue the chapter, the poem Road Not Taken. We came to discuss in the previous stanza that the poet admits the fact that in human nature it's very common to get a kind of feeling of dissatisfaction, to always feel anxious about the road that we could not travel, no matter whether you are a successful man or you are unsuccessful in your career. We came to discuss about that. Robert Frost is also not an exception in this regard. Robert Frost, being a very famous, a very popular poet in both America and in England, he admits the fact that he could not travel on both the roads. We came to discuss about that. Robert Frost, being a poet, has been very famous in both of these countries, and even today his many of the poems are for studies. Thus we know that Robert Frost had a very successful career, but even then he also had the same feeling of anxiety and botherations regarding the road that he could not travel. In the third stanza, we came to discuss about that Robert Frost, at the time when he decided to travel on the second road, he had a feeling that he would come back, if possible, he would like to come back to the very same juncture where he take the deviation and would have a journey by the first road if time ever grants him to do so. That at the same moment also he admits the fact that he knows the fact that it is never ever possible, because once you take a decision, that decision will lead you to another decision, that circumstance will lead you to another circumstance, that atmosphere will create another atmosphere, and your life will be simply going along with that, all things there. So it is never ever easy to reverse your any decision and go back to the previous year, previous time that has already gone away from you. Now let us think about the last stanza. I shall be telling with a sigh, somewhere ages and ages hence, two roads diverged in a wood and I took the one less travelled by, and that has made all the difference. So he says, I shall be telling this with a sigh. I shall be telling this with a sigh. The word sigh we have already come across in the previous chapter also. We came to the Maggie's side. There was a sigh, and this chapter also, in this poem also, there is the same word comes there, sigh. But while you check the dictionary, the word sigh has a meaning that it is a deep breath, and the deep breath can be of two causes. One of utter satisfaction, and one is of utter dissatisfaction. A sigh can be of satisfaction, happiness, relax. But a sigh can be also that of a disappointment, loss, grief, and a sorrow. Here, the critics have two opinions. That some says that Robert Frost sighed because of his failurity, because he was disappointed. But we must believe, as a successful poet, Robert Frost was happy. Robert Frost was satisfied at his decision. When he turns back to his decision, when he looks back into the decision that he had taken at the time of his youth, at the time of his young age, when he thinks about the very same day years ago, years later, I shall be telling this with a sigh. Whenever I will tell about this story, about my one decision, about the road that I took, the road that I did not take, whenever I tell about this story later, somewhere ages and ages hence, Hence here means in future. In future, long years ago, after many years, at my old age, last time of my life, whenever I turn back to my life, whenever I will revise this incident, then I shall be telling this with a sigh. And of course, I am of the opinion that I am with those critics who say that this sigh is a sigh of satisfaction. This sigh is a sigh of relaxation. This sigh is a sigh of successful completion of a good career. This sigh is a sigh of a conqueror. This sigh is a sigh of a victor. This sigh is a sigh of a winner who had conquered the world of literature, who had conquered the world of English language in two big nations, that is of England and of America. So he admits that whenever I will tell about this decision later in my life, then I shall be telling this with a sigh. What is that sigh? I will be satisfied because I took the right road. Two roads diverged and they would, of course, I will be telling this with a sigh of satisfaction because there were two options before me. Two roads diverged and I would, and I. He stopped there. He paused there. Why? Because, and I, because he is quite relaxed. And I took the one less traveled by. I took the one that is traveled by only few people. My dear children, it is very easy to merge your voice with others, but it is very difficult to create your own sound there. The people, those who had changed the world, the people, those who had shivered the world, the people, those who had brought in some revolution to the world there, of course, they had a different voice. They had a different opinion. They had a different concept of, different vision of the life there. And that's why they were first criticized by the people. They were first thrown out by the people. They were first challenged by the people. Later on, they were admitted and accepted by the people. My dear students, if you want to change the world, first you have to create your own a different voice there. When your voice is so different from that of others there, of course, you may not have many followers at the beginning, but when the time will pass by slowly, people will come to your way. People will listen to you properly. People will hear you with the Lord, with the wholeheartedness there. So Robert Frost, being a traveler, he was not ready to travel with that crowd because he knew that from a crowd, it is very, very difficult to create your own identity. But when you travel at the way of difficulties, when there are not many people going, when you travel all alone there, of course, people will recognize you. People will definitely understand you, but you have to struggle a lot in the beginning. So I took the less traveled by. So I, being a single traveler, stood there for a long time and took the right decision. I went on to the road that was traveled by very few people only. By the less traveled road I took, and that has made all the difference. And that decision had made all the difference in my life. So my dear children, your one decision will change your life. And your one decision, because when one decision is taken, your one decision will lead to another decision. And of course, your life, not only yours, but many people around you, many people within you, many people with you, many people in your family, in your society, in your locality, all the lives of these people will be largely, greatly or shortly affected by your one decision today. So, like Robert Frost, let us also take some right decisions in our life whenever it requires. Thank you.